1 year ago today, News 8 was on the scene of the murder of 83-year-old Erma Kaylor in Lancaster. Tonight, her killer is still on the loose. News 8's Lancaster reporter Katelyn Smith returns to the neighborhood and takes us inside the home where the crime happened.
Ryder, be careful.
Tanisha Figueroa and her two daughters have lived on West Vine Street for 8 months. Neighbors, not her landlord, filled her in on the murder that happened here 4 months before.
Like, you know, this is where the lady lived, where, you know, I was like, really?
Tanisha lives in the home where 83-year-old Erma Kaylor lived half her life until someone took it from her.
Yeah, supposedly it was in the kitchen. There's different stories. One says it was in the living room, others in the kitchen.
Court documents show Kaylor was likely attacked on her living room sofa. Her body was found on the kitchen floor with cuts on her neck. The only sign that something happened here when Tanisha moved in, a piece of evidence tape was stuck to her back door. And still today, you can see the markings from where it was.
So I kind of peeled that off as soon as I moved in. It was kind of strange.
But most of the time, it doesn't bother her. She got a deal on the one-bedroom, one-bath home, $500 a month.
About a month after I moved in, there was a paper in my mailbox with her picture on it, which was really strange.
How far did you go? Did you go all the way down?
Police were trying to get new leads, offering a reward for help finding Erma Kaylor's killer.
And sometimes it's not that we don't necessarily know what happened. We just maybe can't prove it in court.
Evidence has been tested, potential suspects interviewed.
As time goes on, it gets more frustrating that we don't have the information that we need.
Answers Kaylor's family and neighbors are waiting for.
I used to call her grandmom.
Why would someone kill grandmom? Police don't even have a motive. In the meantime,
I lock my doors and my windows.
In Lancaster, Katelyn Smith, News 8.
Now, a woman who visited the neighborhood the day of Erma Kaylor's murder is now calling for the state attorney general's office to investigate. Becky Holzinger wrote about the crime on her website and talked to neighbors after the killing. Today, she set up in front of the Lancaster City Police Station, asking passerbys to sign a petition for a state investigation through a fresh set of eyes.
And it's been a year, and I've kind of followed the crime, and I don't understand why no one's been arrested.
Holzinger says she has about 100 signatures, but doesn't know when she'll present it to the attorney general.